Hey everyone, how is it going? Thompson back again in action with some more heroes and generals. And something that I just want to talk about before I truly begin is why have I not been putting up videos lately? Or at least not daily, which is what my plan originally had been about a week or so ago, maybe two now. Simple explanation. Oh, let me kill this guy. And then I'll be... Oh, he's down. Simple explanation is... Well, there is no simple explanation. That's basically it. Basically, number one, I haven't been feeling well. I have a... Well, I guess you could call it a condition that is called... Daily persistent onset headaches, migraines, something like that. Basically what it is I get migraines every day. And yeah, it's not very fun. I've learned to deal with it, but they've been, don't run over me, please. Oh, great. Oops. They've been especially bad over the past couple days. So that is one reason for it. And I can't talk very well when I have one. I can still talk, I can still play games. In fact, playing games is how you pass them. But yeah, so that's one of the reasons. The other reason is that my games, or my heart just hasn't been into any other games lately other than this game. I've tried playing World of Tanks, I've tried playing War Thunder, let's see. Did I just see a flash over here? Yes. Gotcha. I tried playing World of Tanks, War Thunder, Planet Side 2, let's see, Minecraft, the demo. I tried playing a whole bunch of different games, and I haven't had that same love. So that's another reason for it. But one of the other reasons is, simply put, that as of right now, there isn't a whole bunch in this game. You know, obviously it's more than enough for right now. But if I was to put up a video every day for this game, I would be finished with this game in just about, 2 weeks maybe, at tops. So that's another thing. Another issue that I've run into for doing daily videos. But anyways, let's go ahead and move on. Some small news, I guess you could say. I was recently approached, about 2 days ago, by a player on the US side. He asked if I wanted to join this group. For those who do not know what this group is called, it's called... Let me kill this guy. Oh, he's down. It is known as Allied High Command, or something like that. So, oops, I'm probably gonna kill him. Oh, good, I didn't. Pick up his MG. And it's just me in here, buddy. No need to kill me. So, let's see, I think it's called High Command or something like that. And basically it's this group of, about, I think I heard it was up to 30 to 40 people, all who play US. Most of them have about 6 assault teams or more, and most of them are very good in this game. but I was recently approached by them to see if I want to join, and I decided to do so. So probably won't be seeing any more German videos, but hopefully that won't be too bad. Oh man, how many shots did I put into that guy to not kill him? So they do have their own team speak, so I may be getting on there with their permission, of course, and doing a video, maybe. But don't hold your breath. So anyways, let's go ahead and get on to the game. Enough of this new stuff. So as you can see, as I've been running around with the M1919 MG. I recently bought this guy about, well, first off, it's a whole nother character. As you can see, I'm only about rank 2. Whereas with my main character, I am about rank 8, I believe. Although I haven't checked the exact numbers on it. But I believe it is about 8. So this guy's a completely different character. But with the recent introduction of war funds being the main currency for buying ATs and such, trads have become a lot less useful, and I've decided to pick this guy up and give it a whirl. Just because it was one of those ones where, oh man, I tried the MG42 and I wanted to give this guy a whirl and see how it performs. I talked about it in an earlier video, so I went ahead and picked it up, and basically I'll be lucky if I can get through this whole episode without switching to my Thompson. That's about how much I hate the M1919. With the, when it was just the K98K versus M1 Grand, and then this guy versus MG42, the game was very well balanced because the Germans got worse starting equipment for better late game equipment. Unfortunately, with the introduction of Erwin and the Gewehr 43, which is an exact counterpart in terms of stats, and maybe even better than the Grand, the M1919 has become even worse than it was before. So yeah, it is, well, I wouldn't say, let's see, where is he coming from? Let me kill this guy. Okay, he's down. I wouldn't say that it's game-breaking as of this moment, but it is certainly not fun. And the reason for that is because the MG42 now has every advantage over the M1919. Both have very similar recoil. Oh, I didn't kill him. Huh. Both have the same damage. But, well, I think both have the same accuracy as well. The difference between them, though, is that the M1919 has a, well, MG42 has a 50% higher rate of fire, and the M1919 has far worse sights. And now it is imbalanced. The game has become imbalanced because they have addressed the issue of M1 versus Kerr 98. But they seem to have forgotten this little bugger. So, yeah. Oh, who killed him? Ah, you. Come here, buddy. Gotcha. As you can see, I'm doing not so great compared to what I usually do. Usually, if I'm using my Thompson, I could go... Well, I could probably easily be at 10 and 5 now, with a couple caps, maybe. But with this guy, it's just so much harder to kill people with, because you have that same rate of fire as the Thompson, with a slightly better accuracy, I think, and a slightly better range. Oh, 20 out there. And where is this guy? I don't know. Alright. Time to toss a sticky in there and see if he's right there. Nope. Well, I wonder where that guy was. Ah, right there. Yeah, let's pick up this grand. Or Gravier, I mean. Anyone? No. Oh, there's a guy. He's down. So anyways, with the M1919, now it is completely unbalanced, because as I said earlier, before, it was balanced because of the Germans were storing equipment. So, you know, if you want the good stuff, you have to grind up to it. But once you get up to it, it's really good. So with this guy now, not so much. And he's down, okay. Well, I mean this guy as in the Browning, obviously. Not the Gewehr. So I think they really must do something, and soon. Well, the MG42 was undoubtedly the best MG to come out during... I'm getting paranoid here. To come out during World War II. It should be reflected in this game. The only issue is there's no drawback to it. Or to any of the German weapons for that matter. I need to stop talking. Ah. Gotcha. Okay. There are no drawbacks to using the MG42, because there's no let's see. There's no... Oh, what's the term for it? There's some guys. And... Nope. Nope. There's no... limiting factor, let's say that. There's no deploy factor yet for the machine guns as a whole, which would undoubtedly help, but that's not in the game just yet. There's no limit in the AT setup. I believe it was in Felbu? Does that sound correct? I'm sure that people who played in that patch and before will tell me. But I think it was that patch where they took off a limit. And this limit was put in place. I need to hurry up here. This limit was put in place so that... Oh. No, I don't. I thought they were capping B1. This limit was put in place to stop the to stop the oh overuse of the MGs, and I believe it was taken off in Felbu as kind of like an experiment, I guess one could say. But anyways, that's not in the game. Again, I believe they are playing on putting it back in. Ooh, excuse me. But that's not in just yet. And there's no... Every weapon up until the MG42 and the M1919 are balanced. To a point, of course. The M1 versus the Gravier 43. Is that guy? No. Both have the exact same stats. It just comes down to which site you prefer. Kar98K. Oh, bike just disappeared right in front of me. Kar98K versus. No. Kar98K versus Springfield. Again, it just comes down to the site's identical stats. MP40 versus Thompson. Basically, just comes down to the sights once again. So, I mean, really, there's no. If you want to get the MG42 that much of a advantage over the over really anything that the Allies can put at it, then there should be downsides to it, or at least make it where the Kar98K is the starting weapon at, for the Germans versus the Gewehr, so that then they actually have to grind either for the Gewehr 43 or the MG42. Because right now it's just completely unfair, and while I don't want this game to be turning into a red, what do they call it, red versus blue scenario, you know, that is what it's becoming, and if the MGs don't keep up with it, then, you know, people are going to be complaining. In Allies chat right about now, about every 2 minutes or so, there's at least one person complaining about the Gewehr 43, the Kar98K, the MP40, or the MG42, and the MG42 happens to be the most complained about weapon, for good reason too. So, that is my thoughts on this subject. Ooh. Ouch. Will it... Is the game breaking? Some could argue yes, some could argue no. I do not think that's game breaking, but it is certainly game unbalanced. Just because we have 8 infantry weapons in this game, of those 8, 6 basically have the exact same stats as the other version. And it just comes down to aesthetics, nation, and sights. But, you know, this guy doesn't keep up with the times, so that needs to be changed very soon. So, anyways, moving on. And is there a guy over here? Who's he shooting at? Just not. Maybe he's just shooting blindly. Yeah, I guess so. Well, isn't that odd? That guy? No, it's just a post. Dang, post always fooling me. There's one other thing that just that happened B2 that I just wanted to briefly talk about. Going back once again to the Oh, the daily video thing not working out. I am hoping to be able to put out videos every Wednesday and every Sunday. I may be doing videos between then. Maybe. Well, if I feel like it, if I get into playing the other games again, then I will start posting videos, of course, of those. But of right now, that's not going to be happening very soon. So, anyways, man, these sites. One of the other issues is that people argue that the M1919 is better at range than the MG42. No. Because of a couple of things, recoil is the same, damage is the same. The thing though is that if you're playing 50%, and accuracy I believe is the same. Thing though is that if you're playing 50% more bullets down range, then you have a 50% higher chance to hit someone. And that turns into a 50% higher, what's it called? 50% easier time to kill someone, let's just say that. Especially at close range. Plus, the MG42 sights is, it's just so much better than the M1919s. I mean, the front sight, if that back sight stop, whatever it's called, was flipped down, then I think it would be an excellent weapon. With its only downside being the rate of fire, obviously. But, yeah, it's just such a horrible weapon. There are just so many things about it that I can't stand. Oh, Mr. Monster Guide. Two people do. We'll take him. So yeah, I use this character only when I am in a defensive situation. But you may have noticed I have mines on this guy. Usually I do not carry mines, I do not have mines on my main character, but the reason why I had them on this one is because I use it for those defensive situations where I'm inside a house and having to defend a point and stuff, so. But that's really the only thing that this guy is good for. Everything else about it is just bad. And I'd much rather have the Thompson over it, so. Anyways, go ahead and peek out here. Well, yeah, one of the other interesting things is that, oh, I got Marksman, yay! That's the first badge. Oh, I got a whole ton of badges. The other, let's see, what was I going to mention? I forget now. But, anyways, thank you all for watching once again. Hopefully I can put up another video very soon. But if not, I will see you all Sunday. So, thank you all for watching, and I'll catch you all next time. Bye.